morning, friends. Today, I'm sharing my simple hair and skincare routine that keeps my hair and skin looking healthy and makes me feel great. Over the years, I have tried many different hair and skin products. I've spent thousands of dollars on expensive products and salons. When I began to simplify my life, I realized that the more natural my products were and the fewer products I used, my hair and skin never looked healthier. We all want to look and feel our best, and beauty is a very personal thing for each unique individual. A simple beauty routine can just highlight all of our natural beauty that we already have. I am not a dermatologist, nor am I any kind of a hair expert. These are just the things that I have found really work for me, and maybe you'll try them out and they'll work for you too. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I hope that you will subscribe and also give this video a thumbs up because it really does help my channel grow and I would appreciate it tremendously. Thank you. Sleep is extremely important to me for my health and my overall well-being. When I get plenty of sleep, I notice that I have less bloodshot eyes, it reduces the bags under my eyes, and I really feel and look refreshed and rested. The first thing I do when I wake up in the morning is have a large glass of lukewarm water. It's been all night and my body is a little bit dehydrated. The warm water also helps to flush out my organs and help start my digestive system. By hydrating first thing in the morning, it also helps reduce some of the puffiness I get in my face overnight. Before I shower, I use my body brush to help exfoliate my skin, slough off any dry or dead skin, and it also promotes new cell growth. This makes my skin look smooth and healthy. After my shower, I use my homemade body butter, which is made up of coconut oil, shea butter, and cocoa butter. It is hands down the best, most moisturizing lotion I have ever used. I'm 100% addicted to it. I'm going to leave a link in the description below for the instruction video if you want to make your own body butter. All of the products that I use, I am not paid to promote them, nor are they a sponsor of mine. These are all products that I've been using for a few years now or several years, and I really like them and they work for me. I will leave an affiliate link down below if you are curious about getting any of the products I mention. You can find it down below. I wash my face every morning and night with Insta Natural Vitamin C Cleanser. I really like how the vitamin C helps to brighten my skin. The cleanser makes my face feel really clean, but doesn't over dry. So I really like this cleanser a lot. I follow up with Insta Natural Retinol Serum. This really helps with uneven skin tone and little fine lines and wrinkles. I love how this softens my skin, and I have noticed a huge difference in my wrinkles around my eyes. I am a kid of the 80s, so I never wore sunscreen until I was in my 30s, and my skin dearly paid the price for that. Now I do not step foot outside without sunscreen. Before I apply makeup, I always put on Neutrogena Invisible Daily Defense SPF 60. I really like how it's lightweight, non-greasy, very dry feeling, and it goes on clear and doesn't clog my pores. I have yet to find a natural face sunscreen that isn't super thick and isn't greasy. So if any of you have some suggestions, please leave the comments below because I personally am still looking for a really good natural face sunscreen. At night, I do not use makeup wipes to remove my eye makeup. Instead, I use organic rose hip oil. A few drops just on a tissue takes off all of my makeup really easily, and I'm not dealing with any chemicals or waste. I wash my face to remove any oil, dirt, or any leftover makeup. Once a week, I exfoliate. I use about a pea-sized baking soda on damp fingers and rub it together, making almost like a paste, making small circles along my face and neck to exfoliate my skin. This baking soda mixture was recommended to me about 10 years ago from a dermatologist to help brighten my dark spots from sun damage. It really does brighten my face quite a bit, and I have loved it. However, in that 10 years time, I have heard many times that baking soda is too harsh for your face and it shouldn't be used. So if you do use it, go with caution. And if it's over drying, I would probably recommend not doing it for you. I finish my nightly skincare routine with a few drops of retinol serum on my face and neck, plus a few drops of rosehip oil to help moisturize and brighten as I sleep. I used to have quite thin and brittle, very unhealthy hair, and over the last probably 7 years, as I stopped coloring my hair and stopped shampooing it every day and reduced the amount of products I use on it, my hair has not been this healthy or thick since I was a teenager. I shower every day, but I only wash my hair about every 3 to 4 days. And it took a few months to train my hair to adapt to this new washing schedule. When I washed my hair every day, I noticed that it felt kind of greasy, and I also lost a lot more hair than I do by washing my hair less. I don't use shampoo or conditioner, and I haven't for about 7 years now. I wash my hair with homemade shampoo, which is a few drops of Dr. Bronner's Castile soap, a teaspoon of baking soda, and 4 ounces of water, shaking it up good. It leaves my hair squeaky clean without stripping all of my natural oils. My conditioner is a homemade mixture of 2 ounces apple cider vinegar, 2 ounces water in a spray bottle. I spray it on in the shower, leave it for about 2 minutes, and then rinse. I am always amazed at how soft this makes my hair, and the apple cider vinegar also helps with pH balance on the scalp to prevent dandruff. These are a few things that I have found work for me. Maybe some of them will resonate with you and they'll work for you too, or maybe not. You are the only one who knows what truly makes you feel beautiful and healthy and vibrant. If you have suggestions of hair care or skincare, I would love to hear them. Please leave it in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, subscribe and give it a thumbs up and check out some of these other mindful living videos. Have a wonderful day.